Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go over an example of how you do discriminant analysis in R. So I have the sample code written here and I'll post it online and it'll be in the description box below. And before I get into the details of how you do discriminant analysis in R, let me give you some background on how I'm going to use discriminant analysis and what it is. So usually in the machine learning context, it's used for classification purposes. So like this sample data set, let me go ahead and read it in. We have 14 variables in total, so we have 13 numeric predictor variables, and we're going to use that to predict one categorical variable that has three levels, and the levels are 1, 2, and 3. So in this case, I'm going to subset the data or randomly partition it into like training and testing data, and I'm going to build a model using discriminant analysis that's going to predict what category, whether 1, 2, or 3, the response variable falls in. And then I'm going to test that data using a subset of the original full data set. So this type of classification problem, if you have a response variable that has two levels, I think people are very familiar with that type of classification using logistic regression. So discriminant analysis is similar. And from what I've read, you can use logistic regression mostly just for a response variable that has two levels. And you can also do discriminant analysis for two levels, but I think usually you can just stick with a logistic regression. Discriminant analysis, though, you can use it for any number of levels. So if you have three or more levels, you're going to want to use discriminant analysis instead of logistic regression. And also I've read that if the model assumptions for discriminant analysis hold, which it has more stringent like model assumptions than logistic regression, but if those assumptions are true, I've read that discriminant analysis is more powerful than logistic regression. But again, my recommendation would just be if you have two levels, just do regression. But if you have three or more, do discriminant analysis. The first thing I did was get a public data set using this library called Rattle. So this has a couple different data science functions and stuff, but I'm just using it for the public data set called Wine. And let me go to a description of the data set. So this is a public data set from the University of California at Irvine's Machine Learning Repository. They have a website with a bunch of free data sets, and a lot of them are already loaded in certain packages in R. So this one has basically 178 observations of samples of wine taken from three different cultivars, I think they're called, in Italy. So they have basically three different vineyards, wines from Italy, and they're measuring 13 different values of the wine. And we want to subset the data and model it, and then use that to predict if we can tell based on the 13 variables where the wine comes from. So this part of the code in the beginning is just loading in the public data. This second line, I'm going to use that for plotting later on. So I loaded that in, and then these two lines just load in and attach the wine data set. This, I've already checked this, but this is code that you can use to check the class of your variables. So like I said in the intro, we want our predictor variables to be numeric, and then our response variable is the only categorical variable. So that's fine. And in this next line of code, I checked the assumptions for linear discriminant analysis. So discriminant analysis is most commonly done using either linear discriminant functions or quadratic discriminant functions. So LDA stands for linear discriminant analysis, and then you also commonly do QDA, which is quadratic discriminant analysis. Linear discriminant analysis has a really strict assumption on the distributions of the data, which says that the covariance-variance matrices for each group have to be equal to each other. So you have to have homoscedasticity across, it's basically you have to have multivariate homoscedasticity. And this is an assumption just for LDA. So there are a couple different ways you can test that assumption. And one way of doing it is shown here. It's called boxes M test. So I'm going to run this code and then check whether the null hypothesis, which is homoscedasticity, is met or not. So this gives me a small p-value, so we reject the null hypothesis that the covariance-variance matrices are equal to each other. So actually you don't have homoscedasticity, you have heteroscedasticity, and you don't want to use linear discriminant analysis. Now, boxes m-test, I'm using it because it was the only function that I found that worked. The alternative tests for this are something called Bartlett's test and Levine's test, and I think there's also a non-parametric test as well for this. But I tried running it, and I think I have have too many predictor variables because it didn't really work when I tried to run it in R. So I don't know if that's a thing that, like, if you have multiple predictor variables, you should use Box's mTest, but that's just how it went when I ran it. But when I've been reading about Box's mTest, I've read that there are basically like a lot of problems with this test, and it has a tendency to reject the null hypothesis. So it's kind of like a conservative test, and also it also assumes that the data is normally distributed, which I don't think is a problem because of our large sample size. But I've read that it's also very sensitive to non-normality. But anyway, whether or not this is an accurate test, this model assumption of homoscedasticity for the multivariate data, it's just an assumption of LDA. It's not an assumption in quadratic discriminant analysis. So basically, I'm going to trust that this is true and not run LDA. I'm going to try running a quadratic discriminant analysis instead. So it's kind of like just a check. If this were true, then you could go ahead and try to fit the model using linear discriminants. But if it's false, then I would just run a QDA. So in the next part of the code, before I run the quadratic discriminant analysis, I'm going to randomly partition the data. So I'm going to train the model using 75% of the 178 observations, and then I'm going to test the model accuracy. Well, and then I'm going to fit the model, and then I'm going to test the model accuracy based on the 25% test data. So to do that, I just got this code online. I didn't even write it myself. I'm going to get a sample size that's 75% of the original data, which in our case is going to be 133 observations. Then I'm going to set seed so that we can replicate the partition. And then I'm going to randomly partition 75% of the data into a variable called train, and then 25% of the data into a variable called test. And then now that the data has been randomly partitioned, I'm going to fit a quadratic discriminant analysis model to the training data. So to do that, I'm going to load in another package called mass, and this lets you run the code QDA. So I'm going to fit the QDA, which has the categorical response variable, on all 13 predictors, and then I'm going to predict the response or the classification of the three possible levels using the test data, and then I'm going to do a kind of confusion matrix of what the actual groups are, 1, 2, and 3, and what the predicted groups are, 1, 2, and 3. And this is for the test data. So if you can see here, the QDA, the quadratic discriminant analysis, predicts everything almost 100% correctly. There's literally just one error where the model predicted that one sample was level 1 when actually it was level 2. And then if you wanted to quantify the exact model accuracy, I wrote this code that will do that. And it tells you that this code has a 97.8% accuracy. So the model, based on this data, can classify the different groups with 97.8% accuracy. And for this last part of the code, I added in code for showing how to do partition plots. So you need a package called clear to do that, and then it's just this function. And again, I think I had too many predictor variables because it didn't let me load in this really big image using all the predictors. So I just selected a subset to show you guys what the code does. So basically, it will show you... Let me wait for it to load. It will show you a comparison using two of the predictor variables at a time of what the discriminant functions look like, so basically the classification separations, and in this case it's three colors because we have three groups, and the black will show you the correctly specified samples, and the red will show you what's been incorrectly specified. So that's really cool. So for example, in white, the model is predicting that this is 2, but as you can see, there are some 3s and even a 1 that's peeking through, and then this was predicted to be 1, and then this was predicted to be 3. So that's just for here, and it will also give you the error rates. Now, if you can see here, this seems to have a lot of incorrect predictions, and I think it's because I couldn't fit the full number of predictors. So I think it's predicting based on the subset and not the full model that I ran that had a 97% accuracy. But this is just kind of to show you an example of how you can visualize what the data is doing, what the model is doing with the data, I mean. All right, so that's pretty much it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.